Stacy, we've been out in the storm chaser since 9 a.m., back when the snowflakes were still falling. And now the plows have moved off the main drags and they're focusing on side streets like this one.
If you were planning to take a run today or a walk down to Grays Lake Park from Des Moines, you're going to want to think again. We've just arrived here a few minutes ago to find this trail completely submerged in water. It's murky, it's muddy, it looks pretty nasty, and it's building its way up through these puddles up onto Floor Drive here, sneaking just not too far from the roadway. So I'm just holding on to my hat this morning on Floor Drive. What a difference 24 hours makes.
The Saturday night finals have been sold out for the past 32 years in a row. So that gives you some perspective and an idea of how much traffic is just going to be congested right here outside Wells Fargo Arena.
When the concert was over, all those cars and all the 4,000 concert goers bottlenecked. They had to get out of there at the same time in that single lane on Floor Drive, causing quite the backup.
No black eyes that we've seen so far here in Des Moines, but hey, if you haven't been up and haven't gone outside to see your windshield yet, it's probably looking something like this.
Well, Eric, just pretend this is your home right here. This is what you could expect if you're headed out your door this morning on Aspen Drive.
Winter driving woes are returning. Iowa State Patrol says slick roads have already caused numerous crashes this week alone.
So let's take the hood down now. We'll close it and talk about wiper blades. This is an issue that comes up more often than you would think. We've got some Windex and paper towels to help. One way to increase the longevity of your blades, which may be sticking around, mine are right now with all this ice, is just spray it a little bit and wipe that rubber part down.
Eric, our producers back in the studio, they heard about an outage here. They directed us from where we were in Ankeny over to the east side, and now we are in a black hole. East High School is right behind me, but over here to the right, we are between Maple Street and Walker Street. You see these cars are stuck right here in the middle. Some just don't know what to do or what's going on. This one looks like it's having some trouble, but that's because those lights up there, there's no red, there's no yellow, no green. Looks like this maybe even gotten a little bit of a fender bender.
Windsor Heights raised its speed limit over on University Avenue, and many drivers are rejoicing this morning. The increase comes days after the city council approved the measure. And KCCI's Bo Bowman talked to restaurant owners who were doing the same rejoicing over these speed limit boosts.
We don't have a definitive time on when the flyover bridge here in Ames will actually be open for you to drive on. And as you can see right now behind me to the left, the bridge still has cones blocking it off. So you're going to still have to take that exit to 30 East towards Nevada.
The roads are just like bursting apart. Mm-hmm. Wow. And the mayor, he was saying they don't have money for this. I mean, it cost them $4 million
wow.
last time that this happened to fix. Oh. And they just don't have that money this year.
It's been a remarkable winter, yielding some remarkable damage. And that most certainly is evident here on 8th Street as it builds into Keough. We're going to pull over the camera this way. You see drivers are dealing with this string of potholes, and you can feel them as you drive over this morning.